Hello, sensuals.
It's been an amazing week. And since the last video that I did, I thought I would switch a bit the focus here. And I'd talk about, sexuality, just a slightly professional approach. Meaning a sexy vlog about my work. So what has been going on with me and the work that I'm promoting, the cause or the mission, as I call it, around sexual development and helping people not getting just better intimate lives, but sometimes getting over some bad episodes and some bad experiences that they've had and that have put a shadow on their intimacy and their ability to relate and to open up to the person that they want to spend their life with. So, it's a big mission, by the way. I don't know, if I have conservatory people in my audience, I know that this topic may seem pretty outrageous or pretty uncomfortable, but yet I want to believe that most of the people that are watching this, and by the way, if you're new to my channel, you're still, I will consider you a very open-minded person, and I want to congratulate you for ending up here as well, because you have a lot of things to learn from. And I do try to bring a different perspective from the tons of videos that I see out there on YouTube on sexuality, which are, they're funny, some of them, they're useful, but not exactly reaching the core and the juicy part of yourself, your intimate self and your expectations, your wants, your needs, your identity, your connection to your erotic energy. By the way, your erotic is your internal universe. It's not something that you can see. It's not something vulgar. It's something that only you can experience. So, that's what I try to bring. And I hope that you will pick this up as you go along the videos. Now, today I want to talk about a bit, what is it like for me to do this work? And yes, I will say some things. Please keep in mind that I've also shared this in other videos. I never disclose too much of myself. And for some people, this may seem like, well, what? You're talking about this. How can you not disclose yourself? Well, trust me, there's a lot more going on, obviously, with me, as with other people. And I really do put a high price, or a high value, actually, not price, a high value on my privacy and intimate life and personal life and the people that are dear to me, whether it's friends or my lover or family or anybody, clients. So I do take care of that a lot. But that being said, there are some things that I can open up about. It's broader themes and it's much more general directions or guidelines basically about me, but still, and about my work, I still think that you can find some value in it and for you. So first of all, what is it like to be a sex coach? And there's another video, another vlog, sexy vlog, about this. What is it like to be a sex coach in a former communist country? Well, today I just want to say what's it like to be a sex coach in anywhere on the planet. So it's been 2 years and some months since I've been doing this publicly, and I am very happy to say that I have many people who decide to take work with me, whether it's one-on-one coaching, whether it's attending events. Although I have reduced the number of events that I do, it's no longer a main direction for me. I would probably just do retreats every now and then, but otherwise I've stopped doing events as a recurring thing because I just saw that they're not very well understood. They can't go too deep because it's just, 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. You can't do much in that time, not with this topic. It is such a delicate one and people are so tense and they are so afraid to just, they don't have to give personal details, just, ask a question. Say something that is generally preoccupying them or generally intimidating them. They don't necessarily have to, disclose anything, but it is such a scary topic for so many people. Although this is one thing that we all do in life. So yeah, I've come to understand this fear and reluctancy that many people have, and I don't want to push anything. It's tiring to keep dragging and motivating people when they're really, maybe they are ready, but they just are not willing to take a step and to do something. So I've decided to use my energy in much more efficient ways. I know that sounds not so good, but you have to understand that I'm also a human being and that I have a limited amount of energy. And if I invest it in the wrong, not the wrong places, just in places where it's not giving up some or not giving out results, you know, you kind of have to reorganize. So that being said, I still appreciate the people that do take work with me, and even the ones that take the online programs. It's still, there's a reluctancy also over there. And for many, many months, I've wondered, so is it something related to me? Am I not good enough? Am I not, you know, some of my videos, like the ones that I do at home, the image quality, like I know it, I get it. It's not great. There's no B-reel images and there's no special effects and other things. And there are many other YouTubers out there and vloggers who, yeah, they have this super presentable videos. But even so, I still want to believe that the value that these videos contain is still felt. And this is one thing that has been bugging me for quite some time. So is it something that I'm not doing right? Is it the quality of the videos? Is it the way I talk? Is it, what is it? So this is one thing that is happening. I'm often wondering, am I doing something not so okay? So because I'm not reaching as many people as I wished I was. And that's kind of like, for an ambitious woman, I can't say girl anymore, for an ambitious woman like me, that's kind of, we gotta do something about it. But what? I don't know what. So this is one thing that is happening, and it's still, I'm still inside of myself as a professional. What can I do better? How can I do better? How can I be better? Is it something that I can work on with myself? You know, aside from putting myself out there and trusting that even the fewer people than I wished are still reaching me, or I'm reaching them, and I get feedback from people and it's good, then I still want to, you know, I want to acknowledge that. So it's still happening. It's there. And it's also, I have more women taking one-on-one coaching with me than men. And when I see these women, and by the way, all of them are either in a committed relationship or married. I don't have single women. And the few men that also take coaching with me, yeah, either married or in long-term relationships. It's like, one thing that I often wonder is, what about the single people? Don't they have anything to work on? Aren't they, you know, thinking that this is a good investment? So to develop themselves and, you know, become better, whatever that means for them, as more confident, more relaxed, knowing themselves more, knowing their boundaries more, knowing the directions that they want to go to more, knowing what they have to offer. Like, first of all, in terms of presence, just being in intimacy with somebody, what kind of a presence can they, what kind of a space can they hold for the other person? I often wonder that. What about the single people? And you have to understand that this is, when I started this work, it was because I had been so bad. Like I had felt so bad for so many years with the topic of relationships, not just sexuality, just relationships. And I often wonder, well, am I not somebody who can be considered a good lover, just a partner, you know, for a relationship? That thought was crawling in my head, wow, so much. And by the time I also got my abuse story, I was like, no, there's something so wrong here. Maybe it's something that I'm not seeing so well. But so I started doing this work on my own. So the fact that now I have people in committed relationships coming to me, that's, you know, like that's the opposite of what I did. And I was, a lot of the time when I was doing this work, I was thinking that, you know what? Yeah, I'm doing work for all the people out there, but I'm assuming that the people that are actually in need or in search of this more are the single ones who are not yet committed, who are a little anxious. And this topic is also, well, not just this one, because there are many things that people are self-conscious about, not just sex and intimacy and physical intimacy. It's the way they look, how much money they earn, how well are they seen in society, what their contribution to society is. And by the way, this topic is a major one for me, the contribution in society. And whenever I work with somebody, or I just have people coming to my events, and we also get into this topic, like, what are you doing out there to help a community, to transform something, to bring a solution or your solution to a problem that you see out there? I'm a sucker for that. And I guess that's the, if I can call it, the heritage from my environmental protection activism that I did for so many years. And I still miss it every now and then, but for now, I see a lot more value in what I'm doing here in this topic. And so there are many other reasons, you know, for that single people are sometimes self-conscious about before they get into relationships. And I often thought that, yeah, this is my crowd, this is my audience. As it turns out, it may be, like, they are the ones that may be watching the videos, but the people that come to me are the people who are in, you know, concrete dilemmas or delicate situations, or almost to break up, or in the middle of a crisis in their relationship. So that's how they end up, or they come to me. And that's, I often tell them, you know, this is the place where things got a little worse than you would have wanted them to. And ideally, you want to take this work like ahead of time. Okay, it's not bad that now you're facing some trouble and you're coming to me and taking this work. That is absolutely, I'm glad you're doing this. I mean, it does take courage. And there's, especially the most traditional people or conservatory people, when they hear about this topic, which is so important, by the way, in a relationship. And I think it's so beautiful to do this for yourself and for the quality of your relationship. But when these people hear about it, it's like, ugh. So, and I know that there are many, many very highly traditional people out there, many highly conservatory people out there, who unfortunately, in their value system, they don't have sexuality and intimacy. Although it's part of a relationship, unfortunately, and in a long-term relationship, it is so important. It is one of the foundational pillars of a relationship. So, you know, but that being said, I still appreciate these people who are in relationships, who are taking that bold step to come to me or to somebody else and work on this topic. And I often, you know, when I work with people, one of the things that I'm focusing on is getting them to a place where they can see their own resources and see the beautiful things that they have to bring in a relationship. And then what can you do, or what can they do, to not prevent, just hold a certain level of harmony and a certain level of functioning and just being in growth and satisfaction, just being well, you know, well in love, and maintaining that on the long run. So, yeah, and with the people that watch these videos, the main question is, how do you prevent? Like, how do you prevent trouble from coming your way? What are the things that you can do? What are the signs that you can see early on? And if you're curious about this, you can check out the videos that I did on holding intimate space, on communication and intimacy, on what do you talk about when you talk about sex. What else is there? Those are the ones that come first into my mind as being the most you know, important ones for giving you signs. But yeah, there are other videos that you can watch on the Conscious Sexuality playlist, because I do have some playlists out there. You can also check out some of the sexy vlogs in terms of erotic or incompatibility in intimacy. What is it? On the self-pleasuring and how you can change your entire mood, your internal disposition with the help of self-pleasuring, which is not a cheap thing for me. By the way, I put a lot of respect and appreciation into what our sexual energy and our sexual manifestation can do for us. So there are many videos out there that you may want to try. I'll try to link them under this video also, just for you to get a sense of direction. So what else is happening with me? Just one more thing, which is, by the way, kind of crucial. And that is the thought that I've been having for some time now, that my personal life can be affected by this work. And that's a truth. That's a very sad truth. Many men that I was attracted to, especially the ones that I was attracted to since I started doing this work, have not seen this work in good eyes, unfortunately. And that triggered a lot of stuff in me, I have to be honest. That triggered, first of all, the dilemma, why am I being attracted to men who are not appreciate, who don't understand this really, who don't try to understand it, who don't ask about what are the results, what are you doing for people, what's your contribution out there? So why are they not thinking in that term? And that's one thing. So I guess for them, the impression or the feeling that I had from them, nobody would say it in actual words, but that's the impression that I had, was that they would be ashamed dating me as somebody who's doing coaching or a sexological body worker, as the official training is. And man, some of them are quite, because I did mention the conservatory people, some of them are quite conservatory or traditional. And why am I attracted to these people? That's a good question for me. You know, me who's, not that I'm not traditional, but I sometimes do things which are bound to transform, bound to bring something new. And tradition doesn't bring new. Tradition relies on the old ways which were seen as the best, the wisest ones. Whereas somebody who's coming with this evolving perspective or transforming perspective or just this courageous and necessary, for me it's necessary, I mean that's what I see this work, but somebody who does this is not 100% traditional. And so yeah, quite a, that's that, this is something that I've been contemplating for quite some time, and I've often wondered, so is this work coming with the expense of my having a committed, intimate, beautiful, powerful, spiritual, intimate relationship? So far it seems like it has, and it's not a good feeling, by the way. It doesn't feel good. So enough about that. That's, you know, probably a sign. For now, it's something that I've been wondering about, and I haven't decided anything really. It's something that is very important to me. It's massive, actually. But it's, you know, this is what's been going on with me. And I do appreciate the friends that I have who are supporting my work. And the fact that my family, by the way, my mother, who is, yeah, you know, in the old tradition in a way, although she's traveled around the planet and she's seen places with her work, so she's not exactly this woman that is highly rooted and doesn't see anything else. She has seen the world a bit, so she's quite mature, and she took my news, the news that I'm doing this work, 2 years ago. She took it pretty well for a mom. Every now and then I show her some of the videos that I do, or some of the interviews that I have with the ladies that come to my retreats, and she's like, okay, if this is helping other people, sure, you know. So yeah, I appreciate that. And I appreciate you guys, by the way. I have to tell you, I draw a lot of energy from you. Although not so many of you comment or relate in a stronger way with the videos, I still take a lot of energy and a lot of value from this interaction. And some of you write to me on private. By the way, if you're writing to me on Facebook these days, like from, what is it, from October 21st, I think, till October 28th, I've been blocked on Facebook. Yeah. This topic is quite delicate for a lot of people. And I'm not, why have I been blocked? I didn't do that much, really. I didn't do that much, but anyway. I'm still learning to navigate the sensibilities that this corporation has, Facebook. But still, I take a lot of energy from you supporting me. And if you write to me anywhere, like comment here or write to me on Facebook or write on my site on the contact form, they get to me and I appreciate them. And if I'm not blocked on any channel, I'll answer to you gladly back. As long as it's a respectful and appreciating message, sure. Or if it's a request for help, sure. If I can do it, if I can't, you know, I have people who are looking for something that I can't offer. So I'm like, you know, I have to turn them down and tell them this is, you haven't found the right person to help you. But I still do that. So still appreciate them writing to me. So why am I doing this video? Because I've been blocked on Facebook and it was so frustrating. And I haven't felt like doing any video with a precise topic. I wanted to share a little bit about what the challenges are for me right now, these days. And in hopes that some of you guys out there who are watching, maybe you also get a sense of, okay, what is this woman going through? That's what I'm going through. So, yeah, I hope you appreciate it. Okay, 23 minutes in. If you're in this far, do drop me a comment just to tell me, minute 23, just so that I know that you watched so far. I would, and if it did anything for you, like if it got you to get a different perspective, let me know. If it got you to be more understanding and more compassionate with somebody who's dear to you, please let me know. So, I do this with an open heart, and I really, really want to help others. You know, the kind of help that I never had when back in the day when I was miserable or abused or whatever. By the way, I'm feeling better right now. That's the only reason I can talk about these things. Because if I was lousy in this department, I would not talk about them. So don't worry about me. Now I'm not suffering. Now I'm just in a different place of challenge. So this is it. Enjoy the week, and I hope I get back to you with a super good video, which is actually, it's not going to be a video, it's going to be an audio, and I'm so curious what that's going to do for you, but you know, I gotta finish it first. So enjoy, have a beautiful, intimate, orgasmic life, and inspire others, inspire your lover, and bring the best of you in your relationship, and cherish that, and I'll see you next week. Kumara kushalo.